Coming up today, Beverly Hills 90210 star Vanessa Marcel is answering your questions. Plus, the whole world.
Nobody wants to hit because you guys loved her on General Hospital and you love her on Beverly Hills 90210. Vanessa Marcel is our guest today. And she's answering your emails. And she literally hit her. But
don't hate her because she's beautiful. Vanessa Marcel is a lot more than the sex pot she plays on television. Y'all probably know her best from her days as the seductive Brenda on General Hospital. Well, now she's changed her zip code to Beverly Hills 90210. Please welcome Vanessa Marcel.
Did we wake you up this morning?
I love that we're all squishy because I'm so cold. I want you guys to get like really cold.
It's like a really humid day in New York too. So what's up?
There are three people down front you should know that are like the big GH fans. They're over there crying. Wipe the tears. It's okay. She's a cool girl.
Well, one of the reasons is because you are so incredibly beautiful. But I understand that you are kind of uncomfortable with that.
Well, first of all, I mean, that's sweet. I'm not so incredibly beautiful. I mean, I have my moments where I feel okay. But when I was growing up, I was really, really skinny. I had braces for 4 years. I had really out of control curly hair. I had no boyfriends. And so that's kind of how I always feel, you know? I think hair and makeup and wardrobe and lighting and all those people make me look
decent. That way too. People keep telling Joy that she's incredibly beautiful. It's hard for you, isn't it, darling?
It is very hard.
I really love it.
But you know what? You're so sweet.
Do we have to not talk? Can we not talk about this?
No, but we want to know how you get around that superficial baloney in Tinseltown. How do you get around that?
I just try and stay really grounded. I mean, you know, all this stuff is kind of fleeting. The only thing that really is going to last in my life forever is my family and my friends and things that are really important, what's going on the inside of me. And you know, the outside's going to just fly by, I hear.
I don't know. It'll fly by in about 80 years, I think.
With the bone density problems.
We asked some email. We have a few emails if we can get to them. This is from Mickey Moses in New York, who watches all of us on WABC, and he says about you, I have seen amazing reviews for the off-Broadway play Starfire. You did it in California. Well, that's really off-Broadway.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's real off-Broadway.
Boy, is that off-Broadway. Are you going to continue your work in theater? Might you come on Broadway?
Oh, I hope so. That's my dream, actually.
To be on Broadway.
Yeah, that's really my
plans?
Dream.
Plans? Any plans?
I'm going to start auditioning out here pretty soon. I really wanted to learn how to become a theater actress, so I humbly took on that challenge. And it was really hard. It's really different from film and TV. So I was a little nervous. And I got good reviews, and I was so excited because I was so ready to get bad ones because I was just learning. So. Mm-hmm.
You talked about staying grounded by caring about things that really matter. And one of the things you care most about is a charity called Sojourn. Is that mm-hmm. right? Why is that so dear to your heart?
I'm a victim of domestic violence myself. It's a place that houses women and children, and it helps them get into therapy, it helps them get jobs. I think that lots of times, if someone doesn't have somewhere to go, that's one of the reasons why they end up staying.
Domestic violence with your parents, something mm-hmm. that's a whole other interview we have to talk about. I mean, seeing it going on in the house.
Yeah. My father had an alcohol problem, which is why I got sober when I was 20 years old also. So. You know, there was a lot of abuse in my household, and it really affected me a lot. It affected my self-esteem a lot, and so I think it's really important to help young people who have gone through that, you know, to understand that it's not their fault and doesn't have anything to do
with
them.
You have quite a story to tell. An alcoholic mm-hmm. until you were 20, and domestic abuse, and that sweet, lovely face.
How'd you pull it out? Because there's a happy ending here. You're here, you're healthy, you're sober. Where'd you pull from?
I really live my life for God. I'm not real religious, but I'm very spiritual. So just God. I think God must have been holding my hand because I don't know how it happened.
There are a bunch of people out there who are big 90210 fans. They adore you, and they adore the boys that are on that show.
The boys are cute on the show.
I have an email from Carrie in Ontario. She wants to know, who is the better kisser? Dylan, Luke Perry, or David, Brian Austin Green?
I have to go back and work with them, so it's really impossible for me to be honest about that.
All of the above, right?
They're both really good kissers. I'd have to say that...
We'll save you. You don't have to say. We'll save you.
You
can just imagine, okay, Vanessa Marcel?
I was just
going
to say that kissing them both at the same time is usually the best.
Thank you for coming. There's so many dimensions to you. We love it. And when we come back, find out which one of us will be modeling the hottest new look for the fall. Guess what that is?